I just wanted to rise and make a contribution in this committee stage to push back on some of what I keep hearing from the other side about Mr. Cheval talked about there was no need to be doing this in urgency. Mr. Burns, the Speaker, just resumed a seat, said, you know, was pushing back on this concept of rushed legislation and implying somehow that we should be taking this much more slowly. Well, actually, I'm not sure. Well, that's what they said. No. That's what they said, Ms. Dalziel. I'm not sure how Brendan Burns can stand and in the same contribution talk about the very valid fear we all have about people out of their houses and facing wood with no heating and yet say we shouldn't be rushing this. I don't know where Mr. Cheval is coming from saying that this doesn't deserve urgency. This does deserve urgency, and actually I think the way we have developed and delivered this legislation is exactly what needed to happen, and I want to commend the Minister for doing it. This final draft of the legislation was only approved, as I understand it, through the Cabinet process on Monday. It was in this House and released on Tuesday. That was when I first saw it. That was when everyone first saw it. And as someone living in Canterbury, living with this and dealing with people, as I know all Canterbury MPs are, this is urgent. This is urgent, and there is a rush. And I can't accept anybody saying, actually, we should slow down. We should not slow down. We need to do this as well as we can, but as quickly as we can. And I'm no apologist for getting this done quickly. On the contrary, we have to do it fast. We have to move fast. And anybody to stand in this House and say it isn't urgent is a complete insult to the people of Canterbury. The other thing I want to push back on is this thing where the comment we've heard a couple of times now from the other side of the House about comments made at Select Committee by the Christchurch City Council about when they saw the final copy of this bill. And I have no doubt they're right as to when they saw the final exposure, the final version of the bill. But let's not confuse that with a suggestion that they weren't involved and discussing the concept and the framework from the outset. They were. They absolutely were. And in fact, the first thing the Deputy Mayor said at Select Committee is we have council commitment and acceptance and agreement to the framework and to the concept. They may not have seen the final version of the bill before Tuesday, neither did I. But every one of those organisations has been involved in these discussions from the outset, and I don't think the Minister could have done more to talk with them along the way as this process developed without holding it up. So to suggest that councillors first heard of this 4 o'clock Tuesday is a complete nonsense. They have been involved, as Selwyn District Council acknowledged they had, as Waimak District Council acknowledged they had, as Ekan acknowledged they had, as Naitahu acknowledged they had. So let's not buy into this suggestion that Christchurch City Council didn't know about it until late Tuesday. That is a nonsense. They have been involved from the outset, they have bought into it, they have supported it, and the Deputy Mayor confirmed that Council, as a Council, indeed support the concept and have all the way through. And I think that needs to be made very clear and put on the record. And Mr Chairman, I will not accept that there's any way to approach this matter except as a matter of urgency. We do have to get it right, and the mere fact that the Minister and his officials have been working through the night to keep making sure anything that is picked up is fixed is commendable. Far from not doing his job, he is doing his job for the people of Canterbury to the utmost of his ability and absolutely to the level we would require. He's getting this done quickly, but he's ensured that any person who makes a sensible suggestion is getting that fed through into the legislation right up to the last minute. I think that should be commended. I think this House should be supporting that. And rather than look for excuses to slow this process down, they should be doing what they say they're going to do, getting in behind it and trying to make sure it works. Mr Speaker, you want to know what playing politics is going to look like? It's going to look like sitting on the sidelines and throwing stones from day one. Anybody who's going to do that is not part of the solution. They're looking for a way to make this government look bad. Well, I know the people of Canterbury know that this government is working hard to get their problem fixed as a matter of urgency. I am not ashamed of myself, Ms Dalziel, because I want to see this dealt with as a matter of urgency. It's outrageous to suggest we should deal with this urgently. That's a nonsense. I have worked with this minister on my issues for my constituents, and they have been dealt with every time. I don't need to go to the media. I deal with it. I work hard for my constituents, and I will continue to do so as a matter of urgency because this is urgent. Mr Chair.
I call Dr Kennedy Graham.
Mr Chair. I just want... A moment's...